Okay, so we're back, still with Sophia Radish. After a technical difficulties break, we'll blame Mark Zuckerberg. And
that's good. I like that. Perfect.
He's a good whipping boy for everything these days. Yeah. Anyways, obviously still with Sophia Radish. We were, before the technical difficulties, talking about your new album that you're working on, your third album.
Yes.
And also, like we were saying in previous video, you've been at this now since you were 13 years old. So I'm wondering, after two albums, working on your third one, you were talking about your love of songwriting. I'm wondering, you know, as you've gotten older and just more experienced as a songwriter, how that's been changing for you, either the process itself or you drawing inspiration from different places.
Oh, wow.
Essentially, how has that evolved now for you?
Wow, that's a deep, I love that question. So I do believe that I've come a long way since the age of 13, and I've allowed myself to grow and expand the horizon as a singer-songwriter, and just be open to advice that I respect from high up people that I've been honored to work with. So I do think that I've come a long way since then. And it's just really the experiences that shape me. So on the road, or touring, and the shows and the people I meet, everything that I've experienced has shaped who I am. Everything that happens to you, okay, shapes who you are. So it's just been a really natural growth for me in my songwriting, and I couldn't have asked for a better climb as an indie artist. It's really been magical. Everyone, all the people that I've met along the way, everyone I'm meeting, it's a grind, definitely, but I'm in love with it. I'm in love with the grind. I love it.
As far as producers on the new album, you're working with, correct me if I'm getting his last name wrong, but Rob
Fraboni.
Fraboni.
Yeah,
who I know is difficult name, but is a legend. He's worked as a Stones, yeah. Dylan, and a whole
Eric Clapton, Bonnie Raitt, all of them. So I'm still in talks with him, and I'm just honored to call him a friend now. He's a really dear friend of mine, and he's really inspired me to start my Canadian band, so that I can have musicians, awesome musicians, to back me in my music. And it's been amazing. So I'm still in talks with him, which is great. But most importantly, he's a really great friend of mine and mentor. He's a big mentor, and it's just a privilege to be able to speak with people like that, and just a phone call away. And he's just love and light, and I'm love and light, and just be love and light, and you will attract that. It's all about that. And just go after what you really want in life. And life's a journey. There's no real destination. It's always going to be a climb, a journey. And that's how I'm treating it. So I'm happy. I'm happy.
Nice.
Yeah.
Speaking of the life of an indie artist, you were saying, you're having a lot of fun, you're enjoying it, you're super positive, but you use the term like it's a grind. And in some of the panels I've been attending, kind of a reoccurring topic is that, in the sense that all the hats, no pun intended, that an indie artist must wear these days. Like, you have to be, yes, a songwriter, musician, but now you also have to be your own distributor and social media marketing expert and publicist and show booker and on and on and on. Like, it really is like DIY. And what all the things you have to do yourself just keep getting more and more. So, like, I'm just wondering for you how you're able to juggle that. And
that's true. That's a good question. I think that social media, this day and age, has given us a really amazing platform to get out there. So so you hear about more people, more artists, and it gives us all an opportunity to be heard. So I'm very grateful to the internet and social media for that. There's of course pros and cons to everything, and sometimes I feel that I was meant to be from Woodstock era. Sometimes I feel that. But really, you just have to believe in yourself and do as much for yourself as you can. Treat it as a business, but be the artist first, but treat it as a business. And so right now I'm managing myself, but I like to say, my mom says, God's really your manager. So I like saying that God's my manager, because I feel that it's important to have faith in something higher than yourself. Yeah. So and everything that's happened to me, it hasn't been a coincidence. I mean, it's just, it's nothing short of a miracle, yeah. You know? So I'm on that grind, and it's very important that you just keep at it,
yeah.
And that you just do continue to work for yourself in all aspects as much as you can, because no one's going to believe in yourself as much as you do.
Yeah, nice. And lastly here, I just want to talk about fan engagement in a live setting. Like, as I've been seeing shows here, like, I've seen some shows that have amazing, you know, amazing fan engagement in terms of the crowd's really into the songs, they're really engaged in the show. And other ones where that's, let's say, less so the case. I mean, you put on an awesome live show, you do tend to, you know, really grab people's attention, you know what I mean? And they get invested in the show when they're watching you perform. I'm just wondering, like, what the secret's been there for you in that regard.
Okay, that's a really good question. all these good questions, Mike. Okay, so really it's about feeling the energy in the room.
Yeah.
And not to sound like a hippie or anything, but it is about the energy, and what you give out comes back to you. So you really have to, it's not a selfish thing where you're on stage and you're doing it only for yourself. No, it's about the audience, because those are the people that are going to come back to support you. Without your audience, you have no one to play to. So you really have to make it about them and not just about pleasing yourself and your ego, per se, on stage, but also just giving the sharing the love and light, sharing the energy and the music. Because remember, you're writing not only for yourself and performing for yourself, but you're doing it for the people.
Yeah.
And artists are kind of like, we're really important in this day and age to be voices for those people. And so I love audiences. And you know, you just feel out the audience and the vibe, and you'll be okay. You'll be okay.
Sounds good. Yeah. And as we wrap up here, where can people find out more? When you have new music, when you have show dates, where can people find it all out?
Oh yeah, and one more thing about the show.
Sure.
You have to put on a good show, so remember that it is about putting on a show. So you have to really entertain. Your job as an artist is to be an entertainer as well. So anyway, so what were you saying?
No, I was just saying, as we depart here, where can people find out about when the new album comes out, when you have a new dates and that, where can people keep following it?
Well, I'm the most active. I mean, I'm active everywhere, of course. You have to be. But I have the biggest following right now on my fan page on Facebook. And everything, though, you can find is on my website at sophiaradish.com. And radish, not like the vegetable, it's R-A-D-I-S-C-H. So you can find everything there, all of my links, all of my social media links. And thank you so much, Mike, for all of your support and my beautiful Canadian Musician Magazine family. I'm honored to be here.
Fantastic. It's lovely seeing you again. Thank you for doing this. Thank you for your patience with our technical difficulties. Damn Mark Zuckerberg. No, but
Damn
seriously,
you.
It's lovely seeing you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Cheers.